I read a really interesting, challenging book over the winter break, and I want to share the core idea from that book. It's by Kyle David Bennett, and the title of the book is Practices of Love: Spiritual Disciplines for the Life of the World. So the key thing that Bennett invites us to ponder in his book is, why is it that we engage in spiritual practices? And when I first heard that from him, I thought, well, that's a strange question. I engage those so that I become a better person, and so that I feel closer to God, and so that I feel more centered in myself. And some of the practices, like practices of petition, of asking for things, I engage when I engage them because I hope to that the world or circumstances might change as a result. Bennett proposes an entirely different set of reasons for engaging in spiritual practices. He suggests that all the things that I just named are all about a vertical relationship. They're about me and the source of spirit, however one names that. And he proposes that the best reason for engaging in spiritual practices doesn't have to do with the vertical, it has to do with the horizontal. I was like, really? So I kept reading. And his suggestion to us is that we engage in spiritual practices in order to become tolerable neighbors to the people and the earth around us. Now, what does that mean? Well, the book has a separate chapter on each of the major categories of spiritual practice, so I'll let you read that in order to hear all of them. But here's one example. Take fasting, for instance. Now, I would have told you fasting was entirely about me. His suggestion is that fasting is actually our learning to pay attention to food. Yeah, duh. But particularly to pay attention to how we use and abuse food. In other words, is my consumption, my need to have that extra chocolate in order to make myself feel better late in the afternoon, is my need for that self thing stronger than my need to pay attention to the accessibility of food to all the people and the creatures on the planet? And fasting as a practice helps me be aware of when I'm acting out of what kind of desire and when I'm making clear ethical choices about what I eat and when I eat and why I eat and who else gets to eat or doesn't get to eat because of the way that I choose to consume food. So hear how he's reframing what sounds like an individual thing to help us notice that our practices actually change our relationship with our neighbors. I invite you to ponder that, to ponder the possibility that the spiritual practices that you engage are engaged not only for you, but for the sake of those around you. And I wonder whether you're like me, and just thinking that thought will help you become more regular and more faithful in keeping those practices.